Hi, Martin here. Today I'm going to show you how I go about cleaning fuel injectors and building a match set. What I'm doing is getting a set ready for my 01 Dakota. I think I'm going to go with these green band injectors that are commonly found on the 4.7s and actually quite a few other Chrysler engines. Generally you find the white, red, and the green band injectors on there. And there's other injectors as well, but we're going to go with these. They are a four-hole injector compared to the two-hole on the white and red band injectors. Now, I've also got a set of injectors. This is part where I'm going to show you how I go about cleaning them and getting to that stage where we're testing them here on the tester. Now, here's a set I got out of an 08 4.7. They are different and are not interchangeable with the 99 through 07s because they're actually shorter. And you can see they are just, they're filthy. I mean, they look nasty. Now, after cleaning them up and through with the ultrasonic bath, and then we're gonna do a reverse flush, and then I go put new filter baskets in them, new O-rings if they need it, and then we put them on the machine here, and I try to build a match set. And you end up looking, after the ultrasonic bath, looks like that. And I did nothing else to it than run it through that ultrasonic bath, and it cleans them up. Easy to see the difference, right? Yeah. All right. Let's get started. When I purchased this cleaner, it came with an ultrasonic bath separate. Now, the one thing bad about that this particular cleaner is the ultrasonic bath didn't have a timer or a temperature control. So I took injectors, I put them into the ultrasonic bath, and went inside and started watching a movie and forgot all about it. Well, it didn't have a, since it didn't have a temperature controller timer on it, it just kept running and it burned itself up. So I got this one. I can easily set the temperature on it and the time for it to do its ultrasonic thing to it, and I don't have to worry about it. All right, I got those injectors right there, and we're just going to run them in the ultrasonic for, let's give it 10 minutes. We'll see how they come out. One thing about these things, this particular one is a little noisy, and I'm just gonna go inside and watch my movie a little bit longer, and we'll come back and see how they look. Okay, here's the temperature. This is in Celsius. It's at 51 right now. And then you can adjust the temperature here. Now it's gonna stay on until you come and shut it off as far as heat goes, but it's controlling the temperature. This here is your time. There's 9 minutes. We can bump it up to 10 and then hit on, and there we go. All right, let's see what we got. I'm just gonna grab the ones from the 08. Look at that. That cleaned up pretty nice. Look at that. Nice chrome looking tips. I see a little bit of dirt in there right there. But, you know, for a few minutes in the bath, oh, there's some stuck in there too. We'll get that out though. I mean, it does a great job. The tips on these things look so clean after going through that ultrasonic bath. Okay, what we're gonna do next is we're gonna take the tester over here, hook up all the injectors that I got right here. And I got this little aluminum tray that sits in the basket. And that way the injectors aren't submerged under the fluid, but they do come up to this level here. And what we're gonna do is turn this thing on I believe it's number one, yep, ultrasonic testing. And all it's doing is firing these injectors. It's opening and closing them. And then we're gonna run this again at another 10 minutes. I could have done this the first time around, the first 10 minutes, but I wanted to get that heavy dirt off of there. And speaking of which, when you get injectors and they got a lot of carbon around the edges and stuff, take a brush, brush all that off first. Get the heavy dirt off so you don't get your fluid filthy right away, you know? Okay, so number one, I hit start. Okay, you can hear that. I can hear them firing. We'll put that on there. And we'll run that for another 10 minutes. All right, let's see what we got. Now that really did the trick on those tips. Remember there was a few that were dirty on these right here? I mean, look at those. Those are looking good. It's like brand new. Now, if I were to go ahead and recondition these, I'd put them in the tester here, do a back flush on them, probably remove the filter baskets as well, and then do a back flush, and then put new filter baskets in them and put them back in the tester and run them through here and make sure they work properly. But we're gonna work on these green band injectors.
All right. Let's see what the ultrasonic did to them.
You look at those tips right there. I mean, they look great. Like they're brand new. All right, I got a set of six injectors, the green band ones, set up here in the tester. And we're gonna run those. And what we're looking for is consistency. Naturally, we want all the injectors to flow exactly the same. But I'm also looking for, sometimes you'll get them looking the same, but you're gonna notice that it's disturbing the fluid differently than all the other ones. And I'll show you what I mean. All right, let's get going here. What we're first gonna do is just a general spray test. That is holding the injectors completely open and see how they operate. First it does a leak test. That was at 120 PSI. And now they're operating at right around 43 PSI. I'm gonna run that just one more time. And then we can kind of get a good idea of how they're performing. Okay, there are slight variations here. Looks like this one here is the weakest one of the bunch. And then these two come in very, very close to each other, including with this one here. So, I mean, that tells us how they're gonna flow, but they're held wide open the entire time. They're not pulsating at all. It gives us some indication of how they perform. Now we're gonna drain that and we're gonna do a different test here. See if anything changes. This is at 60 PSI. You see how this one right here is disturbing the fluid more? Let those bubbles settle. I think I need new fluid because generally you don't see all these bubbles. They settle down real quick with this calibration fluid. Now if you're looking at them, I mean they're all very close. This one here seems to be the strongest one of them. I mean as far as it pushed out the most fluid. These two and this one were a tie, which is a good thing. And then these two were a tie, but came in close to this one here. You're going to start a match set. You might be good to grab this one and this one here, and because they are very close. So what I'm going to do now is change out a few of these injectors, the ones that I feel didn't match. We'll take the three that match. I'm going to put them off to one side, and we'll see if we can get three more that'll match those. Okay, with a new set of injectors over here, these three are new. These three are the ones that we had matched. Let's see what happens. That set there is looking pretty good. They're all within one mark, you know, from this mark right here to the next one up.
Yeah, actually they're even closer than that. So
I'm pretty happy with those six. Now to find two more that flow is equal to these. I'll remove two of these, replace them with two other ones, and we'll hopefully they flow the same.
I tell you, those look really very close.
I think we're gonna call that good.
Finally, I got a match set with these two and those six. We got it. And I went through a lot of injectors. I got five more sitting here and these seven total to make, you know, what is that? The eight and the seven. So out of 15 injectors, I was able to get a match set. Here's a great way to get injectors that aren't working. Watch here. There, you see that? Tap on them. Got one right down here. Bam. And away they go. So there you have it. So if you ever got injectors on your vehicle that aren't working, give them a little tap with a screwdriver handle, and generally they'll take right off again. But there's probably also an indication that something is probably wrong with your injector or your fuel system, like it's dirty or getting clogged or varnished up. But that's a quick way to get them working. Even brand new injectors will sometimes do that. All right, there we have it. Got the injectors, a whole full set of eight, ready to go in my Dakota. Got them bagged up, keep any dust off of them. Hope you enjoyed this video, found it helpful and informative, and if you did, I sure appreciate the thumbs up. Never subscribed to me before, please hit that subscribe button right down there and that little bell symbol right next to it. That way you get notified of the next video I upload. And I'm also an Amazon affiliate. Please check out the description below where you'll find tools and products that we used in the video. And you can do all your Amazon shopping through one of those links. And then the channel earns a small commission. I sure appreciate that. And make sure you do subscribe, and that way you get to see me install these new injectors on my Dakota and see how well they perform. Hopefully a little better performance and a lot better gas mileage, especially with today's gas prices, right? I want to thank you all for watching, and I will see you on the next one.